Good day and welcome back. In this video, we are going to talk about vertical circular motion. We are going to look at a few problems to understand about vertical circular motion. The solution might be like what happened in a uniform horizontal circular motion, but there is something that changed during the motion. Let us study the first case that has constant speed, a question from trial paper of Johor in 2020. We have a bucket with water of mass 2 kg is rotated at constant speed in a vertical circular path. The bucket makes one complete revolution in 4.2 seconds, and this is the period of the circular motion. Hence, we can obtain the angular velocity 2 pi over t is equal to 1.5 radian per second. And then, we also can calculate the linear speed is equal to 11.97 meter per second. Now, let's study about the motion in detail. First of all, we have learned about the centripetal force that exists when the object is in a circular motion. At position A, the bucket is subjected to the tension in the string and also the gravitational force. So here, we have the sum of tension and the weight is the centripetal force. Solving this equation can give us the value of the tension in the string is 16.29 Newton. Next is at position B. The tension is in outward direction while the weight is in downward direction. So we have T minus mg is the centripetal force. Solving this will give us the tension is 55.53 Newton. Lastly is position C. Tension is equal to the centripetal force and it is 35.91 Newton. So from here, we could observe the tension in the string is keep changing when the object is moving in a vertical circular path. It is minimum when the object is at the top of circular path and it is maximum when it is at the bottom. There is something to take note. We have a requirement of minimum velocity in order to make a complete circular motion. This is achieved when the tension is still there, which means it is a non-zero value. From the derivation here, the centripetal force must be larger than the weight of the object, where it depends on the velocity of the object. Solving the equation here, the minimum velocity must be greater than 6.54 meters per second, which is already achieved by the bucket in this case, so it can successfully make complete vertical circular motion with the water inside the bucket. Next, we're going to look at another example, which is non-uniform vertical circular motion. This was tested in 2019. The marble is released from P on a semicircular pipe with radius 2 meters. Given the mass of marble is 500 g, what is the centripetal force? Well, we can connect this question to the conservation of energy. The marble is released from P, which is 2 meters above the position Q. There is conversion of energy from the potential to the kinetic energy. Solving the equation of mgh equal to half mv squared, we can obtain the velocity at Q is 6.26 meters per second. And then we can apply the formula of centripetal force mv squared over r. The centripetal force is equal to 9.8 Newton in this case. So what you could observe in this case is that the linear velocity is non-uniform. Centripetal force is also not constant. Unlike in the previous case, the tension in the string is adjusted so the object can maintain its linear speed. So something extra for you to learn. You can try yourself to rotate a string with a mass. Try to maintain the speed of the object and you will feel that you need to apply different tension in the string in order to do so. Without your help, the speed of the object is changing based on its position. And if the speed is not fast enough, it couldn't make a complete vertical circular motion. Now, let us upgrade the question from the trial paper of SMK METHODIST KL in 2022. A carriage is released from rest at the position X and moved down the track to complete a vertical loop. Before we discuss further, let's see one related simulation here. This is from the PHET website, which I have attached the link below if you're interested to try. By the way, I've tried my best to draw the track as close as the circular path, but this will be good enough to demonstrate the case. Before that, make sure you untick the option of stick to path on the right if you are performing the simulation. First simulation is about the girl is released from the tallest height. We can see that the girl has successfully to make a vertical loop. And now let's try to reduce the height. As you can see, the girl seems lower than previous cast and she couldn't make it. The gravitational force will pull her down and tragic happened. Next, we will reduce the height further. And you can see that the girl still couldn't make it, but she is making a simple harmonic motion. So in conclusion, if you don't have enough linear speed or you don't have enough height, you couldn't perform the circular motion, but only a simple harmonic motion like the skateboard activity. So let's come back to the question. Based on the first example in this video, we have learned how to obtain the minimum required velocity. Here we have the reaction force between the object and the track instead of the tension. The reaction force also must be more than zero. So doing the same calculation steps here, you can get the minimum velocity is 9.9 meter per second. This means the carriage must move at 9.9 meter per second when it is at the position P. The velocity is obtained from the conversion of potential energy, like the second example in this video. We can just consider the position at X and P. The difference in height can be expressed as h minus 20 meter. Put into the equation, we can calculate the difference in height is equal to 5 meter, so the total height h is equal to 25 meter in this case. So that's conclude my discussion today. If you still have any questions, leave it in the comment section below. Also, please do leave a like and subscribe to my channel. I will see you in my next video. Thank you.